Did you know you can use Google Sheets to create a Gantt chart? With the timeline feature, it's very easy to do it. First, we create our table headers, task, start and end dates, tag, status, and progress. Next, we add data validation to our dates columns. That way we don't have to type in our dates and instead can select it from the calendar. The next thing to do is add data validation to our status column. I chose to use to do, done, and doing as in the Kanban system, but you can choose whatever you prefer. In order to have a visual representation of your progress, copy and paste this formula into your column F. For the tag column, we're going to use conditional formatting. That will allow us to color code our tasks based on the type of task. You can also use it for different departments in your organization if that makes more sense for you. This color coding will also be shown in our Gantt chart later. The last step before creating a Gantt chart is populating our table. Add some tasks you have in the upcoming days or copy mine. Finally, you're going to select all your data, click Insert and Timeline. To configure a Gantt chart, you're going to have to select which field refers to each column. Once you do that, you're basically ready to go. You can also group the cards based on different columns. So in this case, you can use the status, the tag, or the progress, for example. This is, of course, a very simple Gantt chart, and it takes a lot of work to keep it updated. If you feel like this is not going to cut for you anymore, consider using Kanbanchi. It is an intuitive and easy to master project management software that interacts perfectly with Google Workspace. On top of that, it has advanced features such as time tracker, attachments, reports, and much more. I hope this video has helped you, and I'll see you in our next Kanbanchi tutorial.